purveji.com. Now today I'm gonna make a very special meal of mine that is called Dal Baati and onion chutney. Now India has a lot of state and Dal Baati is representing one state, Rajasthan and even Madhya Pradesh. Now this is the main meal from that state. India, in each and every state India has its own particular meal, and I just really love Dal Baati because my sister was staying very near to the border of Rajasthan and I just used to visit her often, and at her place I tried first time this Dal Baati, and then after I'm a very huge fan of Dal Baati, and every time I visited her place I always ask her to make a Dal Baati, or either we go out for, you know, Dal Baati dhaba, roadside restaurant, small restaurant dhaba, they make such a really and beautiful and tasty Dal Baati. So yeah, here is the introduction of Dal Baati. Now what is exactly Dal Baati? Like, dal is basically the mix of the different lentils. Now mostly I use urad dal and moong dal because I used to eat it even at her place also, and in restaurant also I know that they mostly use this both. So I always make this with two lentils, but if you want to, you know, skip this two, and if you want to add something else, other lentils, definitely go ahead and add it. And baati means small back buns, like made from a wheat flour. And typical baati should be made on a open fire. They roast it in an open fire and it tastes amazing. But here, since we have only oven it at our place, so definitely we have to bake it in our oven. So yeah, that's it for the introduction of a dal baati. Now first of all, I'm going to make an onion chutney, and later on we are going to make a dal and baati. So let's see how to make this dal baati and onion chutney. Okay friends, so my pan is getting hot now, and first of all, I'm going to make onion chutney. Now it's a very simple chutney, and it's also take very less time to make. So now I'm going to add oil into it. Now in this chutney we need some more oil because we have to, you know, mix it with baati. So that's why dry chutney will not go with baati. So let's just add some oil. Almost 4 tablespoons. That's perfect. And it's, my pan is already hot and oil is also hot. So now I'm going to add onion to it. I hope you can see it. Now I'm not going to make it until, you know, it's a golden brown, but definitely I'm going to cook it, because we don't want a raw flavor of onion into our chutney. So maybe it will take around 2 minutes until we just, you know, stop our roasting. So friends, my onion has been cooking since 2 minutes now, and it's even cooked, it's look cooked, and the raw flavor of the onion is gone now. So into that I'm going to add a crushed garlic. Just going to mix it. I want to keep the strong flavor of garlic into my chutney, so that's why I'm adding it right now. And now I'm going to off my stove and let it just mix very well. And now I'm going to add some salt too. Okay, as for the taste, and that's it. And I also want to add red chili powder into it, but after 1 minute I will going to add, because oil is very hot and I don't want to burn my red chili powder. So friends, it's 1 minute now, and now I'm going to add red chili powder. Now it's depend upon your taste that how much spicy chutney you would like. So I really like a spicy chutney, so I'm going to add more chili powder to it. That's it. And again I'm going to mix this, and it's very simple chutney and it tastes delicious with a dal baati. So friends, I wanted to show you the chutney. It's look really amazing and it has really nice red color. So yeah, that's it. Now let's make our dal. So friends, now as our chutney is done, so I'm going to make dal now. Dal is also really very simple. So on your stove, and one more thing that you have to boil your dal before. Now I have taken, as I already told you, that I have taken urad dal and mung dal. Let me show you how it look like. Urad dal will look like that, and mung dal will look like that. I hope you can see it. So yeah, so this both dal I have taken. Now all the measurement and detailed ingredients are there on my site, that is www.crazyforveggie.com. So I have even boiled my dal, so let me show you how much we have to boil it. I hope, let me show you. I hope you can see it. Oh man, yeah, like that. Now see, I really like, you know, texture in my all dal. So I generally didn't crush it, but if you like to have, you know, smooth dal, so you can simply crush it in a blender or mixer. Go ahead, whatever you like. Now I have added simply the salt and turmeric powder to my dal, and I have just boiled it. So now I'm going to keep my flame on low to medium, and I'm going to just mix it. Now another thing, that this dal is a little bit thinner, so I'm going to add some water into it to make it thinner. Okay, so here is my dal boiling, and keep now your flame on a low. Now I'm going to add a warm water to it. I will judge the consistency first, but, how much thin I want. I would like to add some more water. Okay, now I feel that's it. So now I'm again going to stir it and let it start to boiling now. Then after, we are going to add spices to it. Now as you can see that my dal is boiling now, so now I'm going to add the spices into it. Now one most important thing, that you must have to use lots of garlic into your dal, especially if you're making for a dal bati, because the garlic will give amazing aroma and taste to your dal. So now I'm going to add garlic, and let it just mix with dal. Now one thing, I'm going to add spices into it, but first of all I'm going to take some spices into one bowl, and I'm going to add some water into it, and I'm going to just mix it, because you know sometimes it doesn't mix properly with dal. Some, you know, masalas are just stay separated. So because this dal is really thick in a texture, so it's, you know, not easily mix with all the spices. So yeah, let me just mix all the spices in a bowl. Okay, so here is the thing. I'm going to add coriander powder, very little, just, you know, it's just for the sake of the name garam masala, otherwise it's not required garam masala, and some red chili powder. Okay, now it's also depend upon your, you know, spice level, how much spicy you want. And that's it. And now I'm going to mix water into it, and then after I'm going to add this. That's it. And now I'm going to mix it. So I already added salt while I was just, you know, boiling this dal. So if I need to add it more, then I will add it later on. So now it's time to give a tadka to our dal. So I'm going to shift it on another stove, and I will going to add some oil into it, around 1 tablespoon of oil, and let it just heat up properly. And later on I'm going to add this crushed cumin seeds. Now I just crush it very, you know, coarsely. I didn't crush it finely, so you just have to crush it like that. And you must have to crush it, you know, because in the tadka you just have to feel the taste of the cumin seeds, and it's only come after, you know, if you just crush it. So definitely you must have to crush it. And let me just, you know, give a little bit high heat. And after our oil is hot, I will start to give tadka to it. Into that I'm going to add 2 dry chilies. Jeera, hing, asafoetida, and okay, now let's just heat it properly. And this, you know, roasting aroma of a cumin seeds is amazing. Now I'm going to add this in a dal mixture, but I also want to add red chili powder. So after adding red chili powder, immediately I'm going to add this into it. Now red chili powder can burn, you know, so after you add red chili powder, you immediately you have to add your tadka into the dal. So okay, so now as I have taken everything, let me taste it. Oh my goodness, it's super tasty and even spicy, but you know, little bit salt is required. So I'm going to add it. 2 minutes of cooking and your dal is done. So I'm going to keep my flame on a low, so at least, you know, dal doesn't stick to bottom. So friends, our dal is ready. It will take 2 more minutes to cook, and then after I'm going to shut my stove. And now I'm going to make a baati. So yeah, let's just make a baati now. And so now it's time to make a baati. Here I have taken wheat flour, and into that I'm going to add some salt. And one more thing, that I already started to preheat my oven on 400 degree, and this is a cooking soda, so we need to add a pinch of it. Okay, and now we are going to add oil. Let me remove my oil rings. And now I'm going to add oil. Now see, there is no exact measurement of oil. Why? Because I'm gonna tell you later on, but I'm trying to add, you know, exact measurement, so it will help. But it's very difficult to give exact measurement of each ingredients. So right now I have added 3 tablespoons of oil, and we'll see if we need more. So mix everything very well. But you know, after mixing everything, your flour should be come into your hand in one batch, but it's not coming, you know, it's getting apart. So that's why I think one more tablespoon is required. So again I'm going to mix it, and my oven is also preheat now. Okay, so it seems like now it's looking done. So let's again, you know, give a try to it. Yeah, see, you can see now you can hold your flour into your hand like this. So we have to add oil until that consistency. Otherwise, in a 2 cup of flour, I have added almost 4 tablespoon of oil. So yeah, that's it. Now this is a warm water. We don't have to take cold water or normal temperature water. We have to take warm water. So now I'm going to add this. Now in 2 cups of flour, it will come out. I don't know how much exactly it will come out. I will tell you at the end. But as per my guessing, maybe 8 to 10. Let's see now. So I'm going to knead a dough. Now we have to knead a dough like it should not be very soft, or it even not should be very, you know, hard. Not So our dough is ready now. You can see that it is not very soft, but even not very hard. Now I have taken 2 cups of water. So one is I already used it. So for 2 cups of flour, 1 cup of water is required. Now I'm going to make a baati out of it. So now we have to make small dumplings like that. It should be like that. And if you feel, you know, in between dry, then you can even add little bit water. But right now it's fine, so I'm not gonna add anything. So like that we have to make baati. And let me show you. I hope you can see it. Okay, so now this is the size of the baati we want. We don't have to make it too big, otherwise it will take a long time to cook from inside. Let me show you another time. Okay, so now the second baati is also done. So now I'm going to make rest of the all baatis. So friends, I already make all the baatis. Now it's come out 9 baatis. I told you that between it will be between 8 to 10, so my guessing was right. And now my oven is already preheated on 400 degrees, so now I'm going to place this baati into oven. It's very hot, so I have to be very careful. So my all baatis are I placed into tray, and now I'm going to shut off the door of the oven. Now you can even directly put your baati on a rack, that will be perfect. But the space between my rack is very big and my baatis are small, so I had to put it into the tray. But if you have a very small space between your tray, then definitely put directly into the oven. So now we are gonna have ice on our baatis, and we have to just shift it after 5 minutes. Like that we are going to cook it evenly from each side. So yeah, I will see you soon. So friends, my baati is done now. It's took me around 20 minutes, between 20 to 25 minutes to cook it like that. We have to cook it like that. It should be some brown spots on it, but we don't have to overcook it. So I think that's looking perfect now. And now one more thing, that dal baati has a very special way to eat it. Like first of all, we have to make a coarse powder. You can even just grind it in a mixture if you don't want to do it with the hands. And then after, add that onion chutney, make it little hot, and then after add it onion chutney into this dry version of a baati. And you can add little bit ghee. Now ghee will be the best combination with dal baati. You cannot get the actual taste of dal baati without ghee, and even butter cannot substitute the the amazingness of a ghee. So definitely you must have to use a ghee. And you can even mix all these three things. You can first eat dry, and you can drink this dal with it, or even you can mix dal, everything together, and just enjoy it. So yeah friends, that was it for today's session, and I hope you will definitely enjoy my this recipe. I will definitely come back with my another recipe. Till then, take care, goodbye.